CNBC TV18 exclusive. Now, our colleague Anshu Sharma caught up with Baijendra Kumar of NMDC, discussed a whole host of issues concerning the company's Nagarnar plant, as well as the 10% buyback of its shares by the Department of Investment and Public Asset Management. Here's an excerpt of that conversation.
The pricing is based on the market forces, and as far as NMDC is concerned, the pricing mechanism is very transparent in the sense that a system has been being followed, and then that system is in place for the last so many years. Many of the steel big companies would like to have a long-term agreement with us on a pricing issues, so that they can plan their steel production in advance. That we are also agreeing for that. If there is any more transparency required, we have been discussing with him. We have been discussing with him, and we will continue to have discussions, and this will come.
Okay. What is the status of Nagarnar steel plant? Where does it stand now? Have you secured all the linkages that is required for the plant?
Yeah. I mean, in fact, I'm very happy to tell you that we are almost in the completion stages of Nagarnar steel plant, which probably we'll be able to, start our blast furnace by another 3-4 months, by this financial year. By end of March, we'll be able to do that. That's our. And all the linkages have been now worked out, whatever is required, coking coal and other things. So it's in the last 1 year, so much of activities had happened, and then completion is in the almost in the final stage. So we would expect that by June, the real steel will come out of Nagarnar plant.
Okay. Will there be any plan to hive off the business? Because that was essentially guessed that later NMDC may sell off its stake in the steel plant, as you are more into iron ore mining than selling steel.
No, all these things we cannot speculate at this point of time, because now the kind of core experience we have is mining. But nowadays experience can be purchased. It's not that core experience people can come. The experience come with the people, and so I don't think it is difficult for NMDCs to find experienced people in iron ore sector or steel sector or marketing sector, for that matter, any sector. But whether it will be having a private partner or not partner, it's all not, we have not thought of all these things.
Okay.
Our focus is on starting the production, commissioning the plant, and get things going. As far as the disinvestment is concerned, the Government of India has put it on hold for the time being. So it's like that. It's a decision of the Government of India. When it comes, we will decide what to do. But at this point of time, there is no plan from NMDC side to,
Any talks on buyback, since we are talking about disinvestment? Any plans for buyback, and what will be the comfortable levels for NMDC?
No, we have been discussing with Deepam, and they have requested for some buyback, and our board will take a final call and how to do it. So they have asked for 10%. So we'll see how much we can do it, because we have other commitments. CapEx projects is also there. So considering all these factors, the board of NMDC will take a call on that.
So coking coal is another raw material which is very important for the steel sector. We here at CNBC TV18 have reported that government is looking at giving the coking coal mining business to NMDC. What is your comment on this?
We'll be happy to have coking coal if that business is workable. We'll have to see the specific mines and how best we can use it, and how much it is going to cost, and whether it is profitable to have such kind of a venture to us also for the sector. So we are open, and we'll be happy to have coking coal if it is given to us by government dispensation.